Hey guys, Kim Stallings, Heritage Risk Advisors. How are you doing? In this module, we're going to talk about valuation. What is valuation? It's actual cash value versus replacement cost value. They also have these things called agreed value and functional replacement cost value. We'll touch on it a little bit. It's really important when it comes to flood insurance. But to keep it on the level, we're going to talk about ACV and RCV, actual cash value, replacement cost value. And what do those things mean? Well, when you're looking at your policy and you get two different policies from two different insurance agencies, you might think, wow, why are these such a big price difference? The difference could come from the ACV versus the RCV of the property. Now, how do we determine what those are? Replacement cost value is always what you want. That's the best. That's the number that we say, if it burned down or blew away or flooded tomorrow, how much money would we need to put it back together? That's an interesting question, because I don't get to decide that, and you don't get to decide that, the bank doesn't get to decide that, and neither does the tax man. So who decides what replacement cost value is? Well, it's an aggregation of labor and materials that comes from looking at zip codes all across the country and calculating how much is it per foot to rebuild whatever you had that we're insuring. And the insurance carriers have replacement cost estimators that are built in to how they calculate what risk is. Standard replacement cost on a regular frame with a brick veneer property is about $120 a foot. That may not be what you paid for it. Hopefully you paid less, lucky you, investor. But it is what it would cost to actually rebuild it. And that's what the insurance carrier cares about. Not how much you paid for it, not how much the loan is on it, not how much the tax man says you owe for it, but how much it would cost at the date that we have a claim to rebuild that exact structure. So we always want replacement cost, but there's a problem. Sometimes we can't get replacement cost. What does that mean? That means that maybe your roof is more than 15 years old. Maybe your plumbing hasn't been updated in 40 years. Maybe the electrical or the HVAC system hasn't been upgraded in the last 10 or 15 years. And so the insurance carrier that you're getting a quote from cannot offer you replacement cost because they're saying that the building is too depreciated. What's depreciation? Depreciation is standard replacement cost value minus obsolescence or loss of use or age or mechanical failure. And they calculate this actual cash value number. And who calculates that when you have a claim? That's your adjuster. Not my adjuster, an insurance carrier adjuster. That's usually a third-party administrator. Now, quick caveat, you can always hire your own adjuster. They're called public adjusters. Insurance companies hire their own third-party adjusters, and they're the ones that get to calculate what that number is. And you can argue it a little bit, but they've got mathematical formulas for it. So we don't ever want a policy to go actual cash value if we can avoid it. Sometimes that's all you can get. If we're dealing with a commercial building or maybe a flip project and you're like, I really don't want actual cash value, but my property doesn't qualify for replacement cost value, what can you do then? It's this little thing called agreed value. It means that you and the carrier agree to a certain number that seems reasonable. Agreed value policies have kind of gone out of vogue lately because that's a lot of extra risk that the insurance carrier is taking on. So sometimes they want to charge you a higher premium for an agreed value policy, but it would allow you to get a little better coverage. So sometimes it's a nice deal. There's also a type of coverage called functional replacement cost. We only ever see that in flood insurance. So beware, flood insurance is a separate deal. It's a beast. I'm a bit of an expert on that also, but flood insurance really only insures you to a functional replacement cost. And what does that mean? You had a countertop, so I'm gonna give you another countertop. Yours might have been granite, but now you're getting fiberglass. You know, you had some floors, so I'm gonna give you some floors. These floors are hardwood, but they're not your fancy Brazilian Koa three-quarter nail-down hardwood. They're like pine. But it's functionally been replaced. So, you know, we don't really like functional replacement costs, but that's what you mostly get when you deal with a flood policy. It's not so much a concern on your regular property insurance. Make sense? So those are the biggest differences between actual cash value and replacement costs. So let's think about it again. What do we want? Replacement costs. But what if we can't get it? We're stuck with actual cash value, unless we have an opportunity to get an agreed value policy. A lot of people would say, I want to save money, so I want that cheaper actual cash value policy, so I want to insure my property for that. I only paid 50 grand for the property that's 1,000 square feet that should probably be $100,000 replacement cost. Give me that actual cash value. I want to save the money. I see where you're going. I'm an investor too, but let me throw this at you. All insurance policies, unless they're agreed value, have a sneaky little deductible penalty in them called coinsurance. I didn't see anything about coinsurance on my policy. You're right, you didn't, because it's listed in the 180 pages of your actual policy that you're never gonna read, that you don't get until after you buy the insurance. You see what I'm saying? Nobody's going to Tahiti by making sure that we pay your claim out properly. So you gotta watch for these sneaky little things. In the great state of Texas, all insurance policies that don't have it otherwise listed have an 80% coinsurance. What does coinsurance mean? Like I said, it's a trashy little sneaky deductible. It says if you don't insure your property to at least the coinsurance value, 80%, 90%, 100% of replacement cost, which is again calculated by a third party adjuster to be how much the average labor and material cost is in a particular zip code at the time of a claim. Not at the time you bought the house, at the time of the claim in the future. Then we whack you with a penalty. And the penalty is equal to all that crazy math about how underinsured you are times how big the claim is, and that's your penalty. Big claim that's not a total loss, big penalty. Now, coinsurance is waived if it's a total loss. If it burns to the ground, nobody cares. We're so sorry. Here's a check for everything minus your deductible. But if it doesn't burn to the ground and it's a big claim, then they start looking at this coinsurance. So if you bought an actual cash value policy and only insured your property for 50 grand and it was a 1,000 square foot property and it should have been insured on the low end for 100 grand, you're at 50% to value. You are underneath 80% coinsurance by 30 points. Extrapolate that math out, and you've got a huge deductible. And this is how a lot of people, a lot of investors, get burned on claims, because they insure for the loan amount or they insure for what they bought it for, and that's not equal to the replacement cost. They have a nasty claim. The adjuster comes out, they depreciate it because it's actual cash value. They do the math for the coinsurance. They whack off that penalty, then they whack off what your deductible is, and all of a sudden, you don't have any money left in that 50K to pay back that property. So there is no claim to be made. People get so upset, they're so confused. In some instances, mostly in commercial policies, coinsurance is waived. It's nil. There is no coinsurance. That's called agreed value. When we talked about in another module, agreed value is riskier for the insurance carrier because they handle more of the risk and they charge more money for those kind of policies. Make sense? So as a recap, valuation is incredibly important when it comes to your insurance, and you always have to realize there's some sort of coinsurance, whether it's 80%, 90%, 100%, or waived. So we always want replacement costs if we can get it. We try to avoid actual cash value. We want to keep those numbers up. I tell my investors, we don't have to shop every year, but we should shop insurance every 2 to 3 years, because those valuations and the cost of inflation for products and the cost of inflation in the labor workforce changes all over the country, changes politically, changes with different seasons. It's all about supply and demand. And so you never really know what your replacement cost is unless you're actively shopping your policies and getting those replacement cost estimators rerun frequently. We don't want to overpay, but we don't want to underpay. And we want our claim to pay when we have a problem. You guys got me? My name is Kim from Heritage Risk Advisors. I'm so pleased to be with you. I'll catch you at the next module.